Hi, this is Paul Salt from iPhone Dev TV. I want to show you how to get started with Xcode. I just finished downloading it, and now it's in my application folder, but I don't have it open yet. So let's go over the process. What I'm going to do is open up a new Finder window. So that was just over here. You click on the Finder icon on your dock. You might have the dock on your bottom of your computer screen. Once you do that, you'll find the applications window, where you can find all of your applications. And in here, you should see Xcode. Now, this might be the icon view, and you're just looking for this icon. So you can switch between different views with this. I typically like list view when I'm looking for certain files, just because it's easier for me to sort by name or something like that. What you can do is you can just double click to open it, and that will make it appear, and you should see the screen. Now, an alternative approach that I really like is using Spotlight. So if you're new to Mac, Spotlight allows you to search for anything. So right in here, I can just type in Xcode, and one of the first results that we see in this list should be Xcode. So if you just click on that, it will open up Xcode as well. Now, once we have this open, we want to make it easy to come back to. I'm going to show you a trick that I use on my dock here to pin this. So if you just come over to Xcode and you right-click on Xcode, you have some additional options that you can set right in here. And we'll just do keep in dock. And that'll make it so that when we quit Xcode, that it's still here. So it's just a one-click open. So let's quit Xcode. I'll just go to Xcode, quit Xcode. The shortcut for quitting a program is Apple Q. I use that a lot, so I'll just go ahead and do that. And we can close this window with Command or Apple W. And then we see Xcode right here. We can just open that up, and we're good to go with Xcode. So that's a quick way to find Xcode. In the next video, I'll show you how to create your very first project so that you can get started with playing around with Xcode.